Welcome to KennyRoy.com. I'm Kenny Roy. This is the lecture for the month of January 2013, and it is entitled Male and Female Walks, Differences and Distinctions. Now, I know that this lecture is going to hit home for a lot of people. The difference between a male and a female walk kind of is a little bit baffling, and it seems simple, but I like to take a workflow approach. As you know, I'm kind of a workflow freak, so that's what we're going to talk about this month. So get ready, put a pot of coffee on, get excited, here we go. Excuse me, got a little bit of a dry throat, so I'm hoping to do a lot of work on this lecture and not too much long, you know, 30-minute rants between switching to the screen. So I obviously picked this lecture. This was actually an Ask Video Mail question from a very long time ago, about a year ago actually. Someone sent in a question, what is the main difference between a female walk and a male walk? And only now have I gotten to it. And I was going to do it as a video mail question for next week, but then I realized, why not? We haven't had a real kind of like over-the-shoulder work session kind of lecture for a while. Why not actually take a look at some work? You can watch me work, watch stuff getting done, and you can see the workflow happening. Also, I have, you know, I've just been kind of excited about this new year and getting back. I always kind of like rededicate myself to workflow. I hope you do the same thing. I hope that you take a second every once in a while just to kind of look at how you're doing and assess your workflow. See how it's coming. If you haven't written one down in a long time, maybe the new year is a good time to do that. Hopefully you're taking a lot of care and taking a lot of a close look at how you're learning. It's almost like there's a workflow to learning as well. So hopefully you're doing all that. But at any rate, so I thought we would do a kind of a worky instead of a talky kind of lecture this month, because people seem to enjoy that as well. Plus, it's been a while since we've really seen the workflow in place. So you may be asking yourself, what is really the main workflow differences between a male and a female character for a walk cycle? And it's probably what you're thinking. Like I said in the beginning, or 2 seconds ago, it seems simple, but in order to apply like a workflow difference, a workflow practice to it, you need to understand how the mechanics of a walk actually work. So the female walk, what we want to emphasize is the hips actually being the commander of the action, okay? And I'll kind of define that and zoom in on that. With a male walk, we want the shoulders to be the commander of the action. Okay, even though with both characters the hips actually do lead the motion, it is a controlled fall and the hips is the center of gravity, and you want to put that over the knees and really get them, you know, feeling like they're on balance but in a controlled kind of way moving forward. It still has this feeling that For the man, even though both of them, man and woman, use their hips to move, the shoulders are actually sort of leading the step itself. If you remember, I did a Ask Video Mail in December that was talking about, or maybe it was the first one in January. Can't remember. Look back in the archives and see if you can find it. I did a video mail about leading the motion, and how you can actually have a character that leads the motion in an interesting way with their nose or their chin or their shoulders or their elbows or their pelvis or their knees, and if you're just having trouble coming up with a really interesting character to look at, just pick a random body part and just animate your character leading with that, still doing good body mechanics with the hips, but leading with that. What you want to emphasize, and remember, in animation, you always want to go too far and then tone it down. Always, always. So we'll do the exaggerated version of both of these walks, And then if there's time, we'll tone it down. But I'll show you the workflow of getting to those two different walks as well. Okay. So we'll do that. But what you want to do is you really want to make it on the male that to feel like the shoulders, like he's almost like letting his body, like the shoulders are sort of like taking the step, and then like the feet are making it happen. Like the shoulders have the idea, or the shoulders, that's why I say commander. It really is almost as if they dictate when the step is happening, what the step is going to look like, where the stride is, okay? So, and it's the same thing with the hips on the female. And this may seem simplistic, but it really does actually work. I mean, of course, there's other things like the man's arms are going to be a little bit more they're going to move a little bit more as a result of those shoulders, whereas the woman's arms are going to be a little bit more overlap with the body. A woman, when she walks a little bit more in a line than a man, because those hips are moving a lot more, she does walk a little bit more on a line rather than the man. But if you kind of like take this, here's what I say. I've always said that when an animator is working on something and I see something that, even though it's really early on, that I don't think is going to work out, I tell them to squash it right away. And the reason I say that is because, for me, something always survives in your animation. When you're working on something and there's a little bit like of animation that's weird or funky or whatever, it doesn't matter how early on it is, it will, like an echo of it or like an ancestor, an artifact, will survive all the way through the end of your animation. I just find that you can almost feel it. As much as they smooth it out or whatever, if they don't completely take it out, then it'll survive. You should use that to your advantage when you can. All right? So what I'm proposing is that we make a really concentrated focus on the body parts of the hips on the female walk and the shoulders of the male walk, and then as much as you try to polish down and take out and smooth and whatever, a little bit of that will survive. A little of that will be felt by someone watching it. So we're taking advantage of that weird property of how animation, at least in CG, how animation works, right? We won't be able to get rid of that hip feeling when we're watching the girl walk, and we won't be able to get rid of that shouldery feeling when we're watching the man walk, and it'll be what we want instead of something that is sneaking into our final product that we don't. Okay, so I guess we should just jump in. I'm hoping to get this all done in an hour, and we'll see how long it takes. Let's just jump right in. Okay, take a look. Okay, so here we have our two rigs. This is Morpheus, and let me just quickly save my scene so that I know that we're not going to lose anything. One thing to just note right off the bat is that, you know, I suppose I'm cheating just a little bit by choosing like super male and female looking characters. I suppose that if you took any character, you should be able to make it, you know, look male or female. I guess it would be a little bit more challenging with, you know, like a Moom or Bloke or something like that, or like a character without a face. But two things. One, I'm not authorized to hand those rigs out, and I do want to give you guys this file, so I have to use a free-to-use rig like this. And number two, I believe that you'll be able to extrapolate the information and apply it to any rig when you're done watching. So these two rigs will do. Okay. So what's the first thing in the workflow of doing a walk cycle? First thing is always to find the stride length. Okay. And in order to find the stride length, we need to know how long the walk cycle is going to be as well. So we'll find both of those things. Okay. So first thing, let me see here. First thing, we're going to go to reference, which is a free database of animation reference. And we're going to let's do the woman first. We go young woman, and let's pick something like a runway walk. Let's see what that looks like. Okay, that looks cool. All right, so hope you guys are not shy. She's in a bikini. And now there's this cool tool. It's called at all8.com/tools/bpm.htm. It's a beats per minute calculator. Okay, so I'm going to use that on, you can't see that on the other screen, but I'm going to use my space bar to tap out the beats per minute. Okay, so here we go. Okay, so that was three steps. Okay, now the first step, when I hit it, the first step is it just establishes the beats per minute. So this one says 86. Let me see if I can find another one just to compare. Walk forward from the front. Here. Oh, she seems excited. Okay. All right, here we go. All right, that was a lot faster. All right, let's try that one more time. I'll do the second one. One more time. Okay. So that said 109, okay, so we can average those. That's around 100. Let's do the man as well, young man. They should have him in a thong as well, and you should see his buns. I think that would be fair. He's walking a lot slower. I don't think that's a good enough walk. I think that's too slow. Walk forward, here we go. Okay, so that says 99 was that walk. Okay, so let's say it's 100. All right, so a very simple calculation you can do. 100 beats per minute, that's every single step. So one stride is two steps on a biped. So the first thing we do is we divide that by two. So that's 50 steps or 50 strides per minute, right? So how many per second? So you go 50 divided by 60, that's how many seconds you get. Or sorry, how many steps per second? All right, so it's 0.83 steps per second, and we want to convert that to frames. So we multiply that by 24. So out of a 24 frame second, how many steps are you taking? And that's exactly 20. Okay, so 20 frame walk cycle, 20 frame walk cycle. So we'll go to from frame 1 to 21. Okay. Because frame one and frame 21 will be the exact same frame, all right? So you actually lose that frame, so it's actually frame 1 to 20, which would be 20 frames, okay? 20 frame cycle. Now we're going to find the actual, we're going to do 21 frames in Maya, and we're going to find the stride length by actually putting these two characters both in their, in a comfortable, almost a little bit more than shoulder width stride right now, and kind of feeling that out, okay? So what I'm going to do is instead of, we can do it centered. I guess it doesn't matter. So this guy is negative 20, his translate Z is negative 21 on this one, and it's positive 20. So let me just do this. I'm going to go plus 40 on this one and plus 20 on his root, and then bring him down so that we have one of the feet is zeroed, okay? So here's a very comfortable stride. It might be a little long. In fact, obviously this is not normally centered. In fact, on a woman, it's a little bit further back. On a man, it's a little bit further forward because we kind of stomp. Men kind of stomp, okay? But we're going to use this just to find that stride, okay? Same thing with her. I'm just going to start on the other foot. I don't know why, just maybe for variety, okay? And, you know, something just a little bit more than shoulder width apart. And I'm going to round to the nearest integer. Why? Because I want to be able to do my math operations in the graph editor, okay? All right, so hers is just a little less wide than his. So let's see here. What's the nearest? So his is like 40. Hers is like, let's make hers like 34. I think 34 is good. So this would be 17, would be halfway. Okay? All right. So there we have our two stride lengths. And now we know exactly what we need to do in order to get this stride actually cycling. All right? So remember, this is a workflow lecture. So we are going to follow step by step. Step one, find the stride length. Step two, get those feet actually just on the right frames. And get the translate Z's cycling, moving back and forth. Then we're going to do the body, basically the body up and down. And then we're going to break off into the female and the male version of the workflow. Okay, so let's get back to work here. We have her stride length. So on frame. Basically, we're going to add, so if it's a 20-frame cycle, then basically on frame 10, we're basically switching feet, right? So it's basically 10 frames to switch feet. But really, frame 11 is kind of the first frame, okay? So on frame 11, we are going to... basically switch the feet. So let me do her first, okay? Hit S to set key. On frame 11, we can actually start doing this in the graph editor. There's no reason not to. I'm gonna hit S on frame 11, and then S on frame 21 again, okay? But on frame 11, I'm going to go to the translate Z of this foot and do plus equals, what did we say hers was? Now I can't remember. 34? Was it 34? I think it was 34. Okay, cool. So 34 times 2 is 68. Okay. Is it 34 times 2? Yeah, it's 68. Okay. And then this is going to be plus equals 68. And then this one is plus equals 68. Okay, on that last frame, on 21. Okay, so now we have mathematically, we've already piped it in, okay? So this foot slides forward, steps, this one steps as well. And this one, there's a key erroneously added to the middle here, but that's just because I hit S to set key on everything. So here we go. So now we have our stride length, all right? Now what we do, this is the workflow, right? Now we have the master controller cycle against the stride length. So frame 1, frame 21, it's going to be negative 68. Oops, not in Y. Duh. Negative 68 in Z. Okay. And we can select the master controller and, NASA controller and the cog here, and we'll see that their translate Zs are basically fighting against each other, which is perfect. They should be completely opposite. And then we're going to select all of the translate Zs, and we're going to make sure that their pre-infinity and post-infinity is both cycle with offset. All right, now if we go to view infinity, we'll see that obviously that did not work. We've got to select all of the actual translate Zs in order for that to work. Cycle with offset, post, cycle with offset. There we go. Okay. Now, as you can see, as you zoom out, the feet are working perfectly against, you know, their opposite of that cog. Okay. And now it looks like she's walking in place. Well, that's great because we want her to be walking in place. Let's do the exact same thing on the other side for the guy. Okay. Sorry. Foot, and cog. Frame 1, 11, 21. And then let's see here. This one is moving forward first. Translate Z. What did I say? It's 40, so 80. Plus equals 80. This one stays put until the very end. So this is plus equals 80. And then this one, translate Z, is also plus equals 80. Grab all of these. Go back to the graph editor. I should also offset this first. Negative 80. Not minus equals 80, but negative 80. Okay. Grab this. The root, the left foot, right foot, or screen left, screen right. Grab all of these controls. We're just going through the same thing again. There's no question as to what we're doing because we've done it a million times. We know what to do. Okay. And so there we go. All right, now as you zoom out, you see again, they're working perfectly against each other. And even though he's taking bigger steps, they're both, looks like there's a little bit of a curve on here. 20 and 100 is correct. Must be a curve on here. Zero, negative 80. Uh-oh. Somewhere there is a hitch. Let me just see here. Uh-oh. You know what it seems like? Seems like the global scale is ruining this. I'm going to delete this and make the global scale 1 and see if that works. Yeah, okay, so Morpheus has a bug. It looks like you can't scale the rig, otherwise it scales the controllers asymmetrically, which is fine. We will we'll make do with these two characters standing the same height. That's okay. Let's not worry about that. Okay. So he's still taking a bigger stomping step than her. She's just going to keep on doing what she's doing. I didn't scale her. Okay. So now what is our workflow? We're going to have this step. Good to, I don't like to do too much custom shaping, but the heel roll, the foot roll, actually controls a lot of the shape and the kind of stride length that you get. So it's actually a good idea to work the foot roll a little bit as you start working. Okay, we're going to lift it up in 3 frames. And then this is a little trick I do. See where it is? It's planting right here on frame 11. I like to middle mouse drag and hit S to give it so that it actually lands one frame earlier, but just have it tilted back and a little bit up so that it actually kind of like looks like it slaps just a little bit, okay? Okay, and then we need to, this is kind of one of the pains in the butt is when you want to copy like this heel pivot. One thing you can do is just like set a key and then do the same thing. Normally I developed the habit of just middle mouse dragging frame 1 to frame 24, frame 21 in this case, and then just doing just grabbing the translate Z and doing a plus equals, you know, the stride length again. So I find that I'm like constantly doing stride length calculations on my characters. So I don't know, take it or leave it. Okay, I'll do the same thing really quickly on this guy. I think my foot roll is 1.4. I think, yep, 1.4. 1, 2, 3. Set a key, turn that off. Rotate it forward, get it off the ground. Middle mouse drag backwards. It's right here, tilt it back, lift it up. Okay, so we have pretty simple like cycling feet right now. And now I'm gonna do his body up and down. So this is one of those moments where if you are aware of the workflow of creating your animation and then doing your offsets, it's really easy to do. If you're not comfortable with doing that, this gets a little bit harder. It's not harder, it's just more tedious because you have to find the kind of like slope of that curve as he's going down. Like you take a step and it's not like you take a step and you land, your body is at the bottom of that curve when you land. You step and you go down just a little bit, right? So as you travel over your hip, you know, that passing pose is the highest. So what I'm getting at is that's not, we normally start our strides the way I did, which is right where the left foot and right foot are their most spread apart. You normally don't start a cycle like in the passing pose. It's just kind of hard to figure out, right? Anyway, so what I'm getting at is I know that I know that over 20 frames, remember frame 1 and 21 are the same, so it's frame 1, 6, 11, 16, 21, right? Those are like every 5 frames. So I know that it needs to go up and down twice. So I'm of the mind that you just key up and down twice, and then offset it, then move it. Don't worry, because you have infinity curve types interpolating for you. So there's no reason to not do that, right? So, and you don't even have to worry about where it is. So I'm gonna go up is right here. Actually, I'm gonna do it in the graph editor on the beginning and end, right? So up is, actually let's do it the opposite way. I'm gonna go down, okay? And then I'm gonna go up. And then down again, okay? So now here's our curve, right? And so let's snap these to values. It really doesn't even matter what they are because we're gonna change it, okay? So I just snapped these to values and I'm going to make the post-infinity cycle and the pre-infinity cycle, okay? Because we know it's a cycle. It doesn't need to offset, it just needs to repeat. And now I can do my offsets. See how he's going up and down? Okay, that's not right because his apex right now is right on the step. That's not right. So the apex needs to be basically on the passing pose, which is about 2 frames, 3 frames earlier. All right, so this is 2 frames, All right, let's try one more frame. See, this is the nice thing about this workflow is that you can test stuff. I think three frames feels just a little bit better. Okay. But now, that's as far as we're going to take it. Okay? I'm going to do the other I'm going to do her really, really quickly, the exact same stuff. Okay? So I'm just going to run through. I'm not even going to talk while I do it. You're just going to see it in action again. Oops. How'd that happen? There we go. Okay, so now we're the same on both sides. Okay, that's as far as we're going to take them without now separating the two different workflows. Let's go over to her and see what we're going to do. So we know that the hips really drive her action, but we have a stride length that's been determined in advance, so we need to make sure that we have chosen the right up and down motion that will work with a walk that's more in line, the feet walking more in line, and the hips swinging, okay? So let's make the feet a lot more in line. And this is this can be pretty simple if we have good keyframe economy. So the translate Z of the part, so you can see where it's moving right here, okay? So the translate Z needs to be brought, wherever it's not moving, it needs to be brought a little bit more in a line, okay? So the way we do that is we look, all right, so these are the frames. It's kind of actually hard for me to figure out what like scene layout, what viewport layout I want right now. I'm like confusing myself by looking at four different windows. Okay, all right, so see as it comes through the air, we actually want the feet crossing each other. But we want it when it places, boop, like that, to be a lot more in line. So let's move this key right, you know, in the middle of the passing pose, right? This is where it's passing. And let's grab all the keys that where it's in a line, or sorry, where it's, I'm sorry, I'm getting so, all right, there we go. All the keys where the foot is traveling, it is, the X is kind of out there, and then when it's planted, it's a lot more towards the center, like that, okay? Same thing with this one. So when it's moving, we can drop off that key right there, that's fine. But when it's planted, which is these keys, And let's go to a key where it's planted. It's a lot more towards the center as well. Okay, so now as you can see, now let me make sure that this cycles as well. Translate X, make sure these are all, should probably be flat tangents, I think both, yeah. And actually that doesn't need to offset, it just needs to cycle. Pre-infinity, post-infinity, cycle. Okay, beautiful. So now, as you can see, the feet are passing each other, and we'll deal with those intersections later. So now what we need to do is we need to make sure that the Y arc of our cog right here, or sorry, this is our cog, is working now with the new hips. Now again, it's easiest to do offsets with the hips, okay, if you ask me. All right, way easier to do offsets than to, again, try to intuit what the curve is going to be like on frame one, right? So I'm just going to set a key so we know it needs to be on the left and then on the right. So it needs to be basically four keys, right? So on frame one, we're just going to tilt it over to the left, okay, or screen right, sorry, screen left. To her right, that's one key. We're gonna middle mouse drag, copy that over to frame 21. And then on frame 11, we're gonna do basically the opposite. And so I'm gonna do actually literally the opposite by deleting this negative symbol right here and deleting this negative symbol right here. So it's literally the opposite I just created. I'm gonna hit S to set key, just in case, all right? So now we have basically this, okay? But we need to offset it first, okay? Or not first, now we need to offset it. We need to offset it last, actually, the opposite of first. We need to offset it now that it's been created. Now I wanna point something out that not a lot of people see. See how when he's walking, now this guy's not really showing off. This guy does it very well. See how when he's walking, he kind of, it, like if you look in the chest, and if you go to reference, watching this lecture, you can watch on my screen right here, but you should go to reference and watch it yourself as well. Watch how it almost looks like, I'm gonna demonstrate for you. Watch how it almost looks like he hits a moment, like he like almost like cocks his shoulders and then they release when he steps. And then he switches them, they almost hit, and then he steps again. A woman's hips do the same thing. It's not a smooth thing, it's actually a plateau. So watch your reference very closely and you'll see what I'm talking about. Same thing with a woman when she steps with her hip. It'll pop out and it'll plateau. It's not this swishy, very, 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 do you like that? You like that? You guys getting turned on? Relax, I'm married, okay? Look at the ring. All right. No, it's not that perfect, you know, sine wave. It actually is hitched. Okay. So we're gonna build that in a little bit, just using tangents. So we're gonna do that before we offset as well. Okay. So everything, translate X and rotate. Where is it? Oops. Oh, I didn't know you could double click. Oh my gosh, that's so cool. Double clicking on a channel opens up the expression editor. I'm in love. All right. So we're going to free these tangents and we're going to literally just plateau everything just a little bit. Okay? Just a little bit. See that? See how she's holding a little bit more? Okay, hopefully you see that. All right. Okay, now we need to do our offset. So let's do our offset. All right, so her passing pose, so she should land and then the hip should go up. So she steps right here and maybe by frame 14 or 15. So this is about four frames early. One, two, three, maybe three frames early. Nope, it's still too early. It was about five frames early. And remember, this is way exaggerated. Don't forget what we're looking at right now, we're going to tone down. Okay, see that? Okay, now let's do the same, just because we're talking about workflow, let's do the same thing with his shoulders, okay? So if you'll bear with me, I'm going to get just a little bit of a more relaxed pose on these arms. Is there a, cool. I'm going to do a little trick to copy a pose just to set a key and then paste it over. In fact, can I do this? Yeah, this doesn't, it doesn't look like it has. One, two, three, edit, keys, paste. See? Not quite, they weren't quite created equally. Let me see here. All right, so that's right. Oh, weird. Copy, paste, there we go, cool. Copy, paste. All right, neat. So just to give us a little bit of visual feedback, but this, we're going to do the exact same thing with his shoulders, okay? And we're doing this before the spine so that we can make the spine look like the shoulders are commanding it, all right? I know it sounds a little weird, but just watch as it works. Oh, cool, we have a little bit of translation here too, okay? And what is this? Is this clavicle? Okay, we'll use all these. We'll use the clavicle rote and we'll use the upper body twist. Same thing. So if we look at our reference, watch how his shoulder moves forward and kind of hitches as that foot comes off the ground. Okay? So let's do the same thing. All right? I have to build a little bit more pose into here, but again, we can use offsets, so it'll be fine. Actually, let me set a key on all these first. Shoulder, 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 and body. 1, 6, 11, 16, 21. Now, you technically want to be watching frame 1 to 20 if it's a 20-frame cycle, but you frame 1 and 21 are the exact same frame. That's how Maya cycles stuff. It's hard to explain, but frame 20 goes into frame 21, which is the same as frame 1. So you, when you're watching this back, it'll look like you have a bad hitch. Well, you do because you're not watching frame 1 to 20. You see that? The hitch is gone. Maybe you can't see that. I'm not sure how good the frame rate is on Camtasia, but anyway, I digress. So frame 1, 6, 11, 16, 21. But actually, it's the same as the other one, so we don't need a frame, a key on 6 or 16. So just 1, 11, 21. All right, so let's build the left shoulder. I finally got it right. I've been saying like screen left when I meant his right. Okay, and a little bit downwards, you know, don't you think? It looks cool. Okay, so let's select all of these and maybe even actually push this one back just a little bit. Not so high. Okay. Set, drag it to frame one and set. Now build the opposite. These look opposite. No. Definitely feels like the his left is a lot more forward than the right, doesn't it? That looks better. Okay. Now remember, we're going to tone all this down. Might not have time to tone this down in this lecture. Maybe I'll make a two-parter. We'll see. Same workflow. We now flat these all, curves, post, cycle, and now we're going to plateau all of this stuff, free those tangents, grab these weights, just plateau those guys just a little bit. See, as you can see, these should be kind of like this. These should be kind of opposite. Let me just make sure I'm getting the right thing, you know? And their center should be more on zero, like that. Sometimes you can make little adjustments like I just did. There we go. So that looks a little bit more opposite, doesn't it? Okay. And now we can offset this. So what did I say when we were watching the video? So it's almost as if his shoulder moves forward and then stops right as the leg is coming up. So the leg is already coming up right here, so I think the shoulder should already be forward. So let me just offset this. What shoulder is it? Oops, looks like we get something wrong here. Let me middle mouse drag, set key, make sure that this is okay. Good. All right, try one more time. So the leg is coming off. So by this moment, let me see here. All right, hold on. So this is when the arm. All right, so it just started moving forward. Maybe it moves forward like that. Maybe like that. Okay. Cool. All right. Now is the time. Now is the fun part. Now what we get to do is we get to go into the spine and revisit the cog here and make these choices like her stride length and how high she's stepping in her in her stride, how high she's getting. We get to make the adjustments to make it all work together perfectly, as if it's realistic and as if it's the right thing. Overlapping the spine is really super simple to do. Now, is this FK? No, this is IK. Can I get FK? If I want. Is this IK? No, this is FK as well. Okay. That's interesting. Wonder how I can get IK. Standby. I just want to make sure that I'm not missing something. That's the morph UI hide. Huh. All right, I think he has one type of spine then. What's this? Oh, that's rotating the hips forward and back. Okay, that's no big deal. All right, so let's really quickly do overlap in his spine. We'll start with him first, and we'll see how we can make it work really well with the how the body's overlapping. So this is rotate X. So I'm gonna delete rotate X just in case there's any keys on that already. And we're doing auto key. So I'm going to just key rotate X. Reason I'm not hitting S is because, you know, some rotate channels, like the rotate Y on this chess controller, is already keyed, and I don't want a key. I don't want a key right here. I don't want a key on rotate Y. See, look, I don't want a key right here because it'll mess up the offsets that I've already done. So, but now that I have auto key on, if I'm only messing with rotate X, then, oops, rotate X, here we go. Then I'm going to be in a lot better shape, right? Let me also do rot X on the root here. Let me delete this, okay? But same thing. Key selected, okay. So I'm going to do, let me actually just select the root and the chest right here and see if I can do offsets with just this, okay? So it would be, actually be up, down, it'd be up and down twice. So again, 1, 11, 1, 6, 11, 16, 21. Okay, so rot X. This is the two channels. We can make this, it doesn't matter what we make this because we're going to make it perfect anyway. Okay, curves. Cycle. In fact, if you want to save yourself some time, you can select all the curves and do and deselect just the translate Z on the world IK movers and do post infinity cycle, so you don't have to remember to do it. I don't really care. It takes 2 seconds, so whatever. All right, so he's taking a step. And so obviously he needs to bend forward after the step. So we need to delay this by like 3 or 4 frames. Let's try 3. All right, obviously it's way too much, but I'm not going to judge it until I see if I offset this controller a little bit more, so 2 more frames from the hips, and then tone them both down to see what happens. Also, he's standing a little straight up. I'm going to just have him bent over just a little bit more. And now I'm going to tone it down just a little bit. And this needs to have some translate. Now this needs to be a little bit more just overall anyway. But in general, he should be leaned, like I said, just a little bit more forward. Men are just a little bit more forward. Okay. Now we're going to do just a little bit of hip action. Just because he's a guy doesn't mean that there's absolutely no hip action. That's silly. So let me delete this. What is this? Rot Z, key selected. Actually, let me just set key left like this. Right. Okay, like that, going in. I mean, it's a lot of the same kind of stuff. You get a lot quicker at doing these things with practice, of course. But I mean, hopefully even by the time you guys are done following along with this one, you'll be, you know, old pros at doing these things. So I don't need to offset his as much as hers, because his doesn't really command. His are going to be a lot stiffer. I mean, look at this guy's hips. You can see if you watch like his belt line, you know, they do move. And I'm going to tone this way down when I'm done, but they don't move a lot, and they actually look a little stiff. Look at this girl. Look at her shoulders. Her shoulders actually seem very stiff, don't they? Her hips are going crazy. But her shoulders actually look, if you look at this as like from an animation standpoint, her shoulders almost look stiff. It almost looks like you get that sent back, you know, from by your supervisor to, you know, to fix, right? Okay. And one thing that I didn't do with her yet, which I'm going to start with him, is actually changing the translation and the rotation need to be offset from each other. So the rotation actually needs to be, is that translation? Yeah, the rotation actually needs to be offset like one or two frames from the translation. Oh, anyway, you get the picture. And now I'm going to tone this down a little bit. Just like that. Okay. We're going to keep those shoulders. We're going to tone those down, and we're going to iron those down only like kind of like at the last minute. Because remember, we want to take advantage of the fact that it's an artifact that's really trying to like work its way into our animation, right? So I'm gonna offset her hips, rotation. A couple frames, like I did his. You see that? It almost looks like it shifts across, and then when it hits, it kind of buckles. Okay. All right. So as you can see, hopefully so far, what you are seeing is basically two walks. Two very similar workflows in the beginning, but now they forked, they diverged, and what we're getting is a very exaggerated, but like super female looking walk and a super like male looking walk. And from here, we're going to just kind of apply the same kind of like workflow to each one and get the rest of the parts working. And then at the very last minute, we're going to just we'll dial it in. Right? Remember, animation is like fishing. I've said this 1,000 times. Hopefully you guys are repeating this to your friends. Animation is like fishing. You don't drop your hook in the water, you know, right in front of you and try to push it to where the fish are. You cast your line way over the fish and you reel it in to find the right moment, okay? So that's what we're going to do with our animation. But with what we're looking at, what we see so far, it's also hopefully super evident to you that these scenes are like the artifacts, like just like the over the top exaggerated like feminine qualities that we've put into her walk and the masculine qualities we put into his are going to really take take a lot of polishing to ever get completely out. So they will survive to the end of the animation, to the finish point of the animation. Two walk cycles in an hour, that would be insane. Looks like we're already at 50 minutes of work. I have a little counter right here. So looks like we're at 50 minutes of work, which means I don't know. Well, I'm just gonna get as far as I can, this is a way. Don't worry if you're trying to follow along and you can't get it. This is kind of breakneck pace what we're doing right now. Okay. So where were we? We just got her hips shuffling left and right. So now let's make it so that her body, like I said, the female shoulders move, but it's almost as if they move as a reaction to the hips, right? So we want a little bit of contrapposto, right? That's going to look really, really, really nice. Don't you think? So let's dial that in, okay? And forward. All right, and now let's do the opposite. Oops. All right. You've seen me do this. You know what I'm about to do. Flat them. Curves. Post. Pre. Let me leave that up there so I don't lose it. Right? And now we're going to offset it. We know what to do. Kind of gets a little bit, you know, repetitive. Sometimes you actually have to, like, remember, like, oh, what am I doing? What am I doing? Okay, yeah, pay attention. You know what I mean? I think this could be two frames earlier. Maybe. And I don't see enough up and down in her walk, but I don't think... Yeah, maybe what we want to do is just go a little bit more up and down, but we got to be careful because this is the relationship between the up and down in her cog, in her root, okay, and that stride length is very, very tenuous. They love to hate each other, those two things, those two channels, okay? So I think she actually just needs to be a little bit higher on the up. And I think it's one frame late, actually. Okay. So a little bit higher on the up. We don't want to max it. See, watching that knee, you don't want to max it out, so you can just play with it, right? But I also want to go to, like, maybe this frame and see, what can I do with these tangents? Can I plateau this just a little bit? It always gives a little bit more of, like, an airy quality if you can plateau it a little bit. Let me go one frame after, make sure I'm not maxing it out. Okay. And I think the down is probably too far down, is also a problem. So we got to make sure that we're not maxing anything. Her hips are a little too far in front of her body, I think, when she's stepping. I can't wait to really work the angle of this and really work that in and see the differences here. You see how shouldery he is and how hippy she is, okay? Let's do the kind of same thing on his side. Let's just work a little bit that Y arc and feel things just a little bit. He's walking totally, you know, bow-legged. His feet are moving together totally straight, right? I mean, that's kind of what I see in the reference. Although this guy, he's a little bit more of a model. He walks in a line. This other guy, look at this guy. Where is it? Walk forward. See that? Yeah. A lot of weight in the shoulders as well. We can add a layer of overlap if we get time that shows the weight in the shoulders as well. We probably use the Rotate Z controller or channel on that controller. All right, let's get these arms just swinging very, very, very roughly. because it's getting to the point where I'm a little bit distracted by the fact that they're not. One tip between the men and the woman. The woman, you see a little bit more of the inside of her arm when they swing their arms. The man, you see a little bit more of the top of their forearm when they swing their arms. It's just very, very, very slight, but men kind of show a little bit more of the tops of their hands. Women are a little bit more, they show like the insides of their hands. Not very much. This is all very, very subtle things, but good to know nonetheless. So I'm going to build his hand forward pose like that. And his hand back pose. Ooh, he's got a pretty nasty gimbal up there. Like that. And then basically, I wonder if I can offset it. All right, we'll see if I can offset it. Keys. Why didn't that work? Below all keyable copy. Let me just see if this works. Clipboard, replace. Okay, cool. So we will be able to copy this. Nice. All right, now same thing. A little bit of overlap on this elbow. A little bit of overlap on this wrist, just a little bit, but we're going to offset that as well. And it doesn't matter because, well, I mean, not that it doesn't matter. It doesn't make a difference what the what frame you do this on, because you can always offset it, right? So I'm just going to flat these keys, and I should note that I'm flatting the tangents just so that the tangents work in a cycle right now. This does not all mean that flat tangents is like how you do a cycle. I should point that out, because I'm getting you guys to the point where you basically have two cycles that can be perfected. You can work like. Probably in production, you should be able to hammer out a good cycle like in a day, and then probably polish it for like two or three more and make it perfect in that time. Certainly a week is like a little bit too much time in production, no matter what level you're at, to do a simple walk cycle. So just so you know, but I'm saying that I'm flatting these just so that the tangents as they go into and out of infinity, there's no pops. That's all, but you do want to adjust all your tangents. So let me, that's a little note from Kenny. Okay. So we were going to, what were we going to do? Yeah, we're going to offset it, okay? So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to offset just the upper arm, okay? And it should be, it should be forward when he's stepping. All right, and because we start normally on this pose where the feet are as spread apart as possible, the arms normally work. But I can be a fan of offsetting them just one frame, post, pre, cycle. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab the elbow and I'm going to offset it. Let's do two frames. The wrist, I'm only going to offset one frame because wrists are pretty stiff. Okay, now I'm going to go back here, copy keys, paste it, and now I know. Does this have the things? Does this have the things? Nice. So now I know. Check this out. That this is basically just the opposite of my other arm. So. It's simple. It's on the keys, it's just plus equals 10. And now it's totally opposite, or minus equals 20. Either one. Okay. So that's pretty simple. Super masculine, right? Like overdoing it, right? This guy, isn't he totally overdoing it? Now, the same way we did her shoulder, basically contrapposto and a little bit of forward and back, in sort of in almost a reaction to her hips. We're going to do the same thing with his hips, almost a reaction to his shoulders. Okay, does this rotate? No. Does this rotate? Yes. Okay, so which one should I use? Yeah, we're gonna use a root con. We're gonna go a little bit crazy up in here. All right, so do we have a frame? All right, we already have a key on frame 1 and 21 for that rotate Y. No big deal. So we're just going to use the rotate Y and go forward. On 11, we'll go the other way. And then on 21, we'll actually copy whatever the heck is right here. We don't care, remember. So it looks like 10 degrees. Let's just make this 10 degrees. And let's make this negative 10 degrees. Flat it. Let's see here. Pre-cycle, post-cycle. Done, done, done. And now let's offset it. So it should be going for, it should be almost timed almost exactly right with those shoulders, but just a little bit, maybe two frames behind. His spine overlap is getting distracting, is not? Is this the rotate? Is it the translate? Do I have translate happening here? Just make sure. All right, so that's not supposed to be there. There we go. Cool. Awesome. All right. So we have him rocking. We have her rocking. Oh, I forgot to do her arms. Ding. All right. Get her arms real quick. Remember what to do? Remember the workflow? Do it. Set it. Offset it. Copy it. Paste it. All right. Remember I said women show just a little bit more of the inside of their hand. She is, what are we doing, scrunch? Oh, that's a cool pose. It's a cool little channel to have. Nice. What am I trying to do? What am I trying to do? Curl, oh, curl and cup, and relax. Okay. Let's bring her thumb in. Spread, there we go. There we go. Set, copy, paste. It's weird. Copy. Oh, this doesn't have a key on it. Set. Now, copy. Paste. There we go. Okay. All right, so let's just build her forward. Okay. Even if a woman swings her arms and her arm comes all the way across, it'll come across in a way that you see almost like maximum amount of like top or inside of the forearm. Whereas a man, it'll come across like this, like that. See, it'll come across like this. Whereas with a woman, it'll come across this way and then kind of like turn in as it comes back. So. And that would be like four keys. We're only going to set two, basically. So, don't worry about that. overlap that just a little bit, overlap that just a little bit. You've seen this before. You guys are all pros at this already. 11, let's put it back. What did I just choose? So we're going to first flat all these, select all these, cycle, then place it, or time it rather. Like I said, normally, that's funny, I did this one basically opposite of the other one. So this one's already, it should be basically like that and two frames. Let's make it one frame later. Okay. And then, let's see, grab you. No, offset this one, two frames. The wrist is a little bit stiffer, so we're gonna offset it just once. Copy keys, where is it? Paste keys, and then this whole arm chain, whole thing, minus equals 10. There we go. And that's too far forward. So let's grab both of these and tone down the amount of rotation that it's doing. I'm picking this spot. Actually, you know what? This is a good tool to use. This is the new, what is this called? Region tool. It's kind of cool because you can it makes a box around the keys you have selected. Although, I thought there was a way. I thought there was a way to make it pivot. Never mind. It's not a good tool at all to use for this. Just need to scale. I'm trying to scale like right on this point though. So both of these, they're gonna hit now. So what is that, rotate Z? Okay, so now she got her arms working too. All right, see that? Now I know it's a little hard to see, so let me just turn off curves and let me just do a quick play blast. And we'll talk about where to go. Oop, I should do frame 1 to 20. My bad. Stand by. Okay, cool. So, here we are. Obviously we have the stage that we're at now is the moment to try to make these motions, the real driving, the commanders of the motion, which are the shoulders for the man and the hips for the woman. Now we need to iron them down. We need to push them back into the body and make the changes to the body, whether it be the height of the step, whether it be how long the foot stays on the ground, whether it be anything basically, and now make them work with work with those shoulders and hips. And this is kind of the moment where you get to kind of decide. It's almost like a dial. You get to decide like how how much do I want to go overboard? How much do I want to take this character and really make it seem like super female or super male or whatever? So I'm going to say that we're going to tone this down by like half and see what we got. So that'll be the last thing that I do. Let's see here. My screen capture says an hour and 12. That says hour 21. Okay, so I'm going to take about 10 minutes to do this, and that will make this a 90-minute lecture. I'm sure you are ready to grab these files and try it yourself, so I'll try to do this as fast as possible. So let's start with him, okay? So I'd say about half is what we need. But that doesn't necessarily mean we take everything and we make it a half. It might mean that we start with one controller and start reducing it, and then do a different controller and start reducing it. This is easy because it is obviously moving about, you know, the zero is the like kind of like the axis of symmetry. So if I do multiply equals 0.5, it'll literally reduce it in half. Okay, I think that actually did a lot. Let me see here. Which one is this? This is the rotation. Yeah, let me see this one. First of all, these should all be the same. And now let me just reduce it just a little bit. See what we got. I feel like there's a hitch somewhere. Hold on a second. Okay. Yeah, I feel a hitch somewhere. Stand by. I just want to make sure I haven't missed something. Aha, rotate Z. What is rotate Z? Oh, it's left and right. I don't know why that's on there. The overlap, okay, so what I was just watching was it looks to me like the overlap in the body is still, what it feels like is that it's not as much a reaction to the shoulders as it is the body action. So I really want it to feel like it though, so. I'm gonna offset it just a little bit more. Is there a head isolation? There we go. That makes things just a little bit easier to watch, doesn't it? Still feel like there's something crazy going on here. Just trying to find that weird hitch that's happening, guys. Breath? Is it up here? I'm feeling a hitch. Oh, this drives me wild sometimes. Oh, maybe not. Sometimes watching from different angles helps too. I'm gonna push him just a little bit more forward over his stride as well. Just make him seem a little bit more stompy. And let's just play with his up and down and see what happens. Can't tell if he's maxing out anywhere. Yeah, he's kind of maxing out right there. Bring it back within the realm of good. And let's have him hang a little bit at the top. Always looks good. Always feels nice. Tying it down just a little bit more. Just in the rotation of this upper spine here, multiply equal to 0.5. Mm. That feels pretty good. All right, so this guy, now he is at the point where you're ready to dive in, go through every little control, start making some really fine-tuned adjustments in terms of how, like, the shock of that foot landing really, like, on a frame-by-frame basis puts, you know, that force, like, up through the body, up through that frame, and how that affects that. But he is ready for basically blocking plus. This is basically blocked. He's ready. That's the size that I want on him. That's the size that, you know, that's his character right now. So this would be the end of blocking, where I've made all the posing choices. I've made all of the basically timing choices, and that's his character basically. So he's ready to start working on in a fine-tuned way. And now, so that would be the workflow for him. And now let's get her, let's take one more close look at her and do the same thing. You know, as much as she looks good as she sits back in her on her heels, I think we should give her the same courtesy of being just a little bit more commanding and walking just a little taller. No, I think she's maxing out pretty badly. Offset that just a little bit more. Now, you know, I'm loving playing with how far forward they're walking. It really actually gives them a lot different, a very different character. depending on how far forward they're walking. You know, like, this is a completely different person. I mean, that's obviously off balance, but, you know, it's a completely different character. So let's just give her a little bit of assertiveness and have her walk a little bit further forward. But she's just walking too tall again. She doesn't have any overlap in her spine yet. But I think it's super necessary now. I don't think it's working without it. So let me just add that in. Forward. Steps. Oh no, it'd be two different. Right, it'd be two. Like that. Right. And then so she steps, and then it's forward. Is this forward? Okay. And back. And now overall leaned a little bit more forward. Not as much as the man. Definitely not. You know, you can compare them. He's like this, right? So she can be a little bit less, you know, like right here. And now we can overlap her chest. What is this, Rodex? So this is not right. This needs to be offset again. Same thing we just did. Six. You can even insert keys like this and then just move them around, see what I'm doing? I just insert those keys. Doesn't matter. You're gonna set the right level anyway. Right? Okay. So where's the rote on this? Rote X. So this is the bottom of this one. So the rote X of this one up here needs to be offset like maybe two frames. And let's find the right amount for this. Like 5 degrees, I don't know. And now I'm noticing a very distinct lack of her hips moving forward. So when we get them sloshing side to side, I'm gonna wait to find everything, my stride length. I'm gonna wait to find, you know, the height here before I dial this last channel, which is rotate Y in. And that is because this is basically the last channel that's going to actually significantly and substantially affect the distance to the ground, right? So as her foot is reaching forward, basically, is where we want, I can offset this and then do it, is where we want her hip to be kind of like reaching out. You see that? You know, for reaching for the ground almost, like that. So let's say that that's like, -8. We can make this 8, all right? And then that's already been offset, or that's already been cycled. So let's just see what that looks like. Now I said I wanted to tone everything down like by half. So let's It's the translate, translate X and rotate Z. Okay, and both of these, basically they're centered around the zero. You know, zero is like their line. So let me just see what happens when I multiply equals 0.5. Just what happens to the cycle itself. Ooh, I haven't saved in a while. Oh my gosh. Do not do as I do. Do as I say, people. That was way too long between saves. Holy jeezum. Oh man, can you imagine if I lost that? That'd be bad. And her arms are way too far forward still. Didn't I fix that already? I thought I already fixed that on her. And now the last thing is, I'm liking how much these hips are like reaching forward, but the body needs to kind of react to that. Remember, the hips are driving the body. So I'm gonna do one last thing, which is the rotation of the body like this, but it's going to be overlapped from the hips. You see, normally, I mean, you would think that you do all your rotations on this big controller. Oh, it's a very important controller, right? Well, what I'm gonna do is this is the commander. These rocking and rolling hips right here, these are dictating everything. So the body is going to be overlapping from the hips instead. And it's the opposite with the guy. I did the rotation on the body in response to these shoulders. The shoulders go, and then I did an offset overlap on the whole body. Isn't that crazy? Well, it's the same thing with the hips on her. Okay, so I'm going to do a rotate Y. So where are the hips? So here's the hips rotate Y. This is on frame 9, it's at its bottom. Okay, so I'm gonna do the same thing, but I'm gonna move, so it's, oh, it's perfect, 2 frames. Oh, that's so nice. I'm gonna go like this, you know the drill, pre-cycle, post-cycle. Gonna make this something like, whatever, 2, it doesn't matter. -2, because we're going to scale it up and down anyway, and just see what we get, okay? So this is where it is at its greatest. So let me see what happens when I scale this up. Just a hair, just a little bit. What is that? 5 degrees of rotation. Well, I don't even know. Well, let's see. This is the beauty of a workflow that's like open and editable, is that you get to watch and then just see. Doesn't look like enough, actually. That's kind of weird. I don't think his is that much. Oh, no, that makes sense, because his hips aren't translating as much. Oh, no, his is 10. Oh, well, hers needed to be at least 10. Yeah, see, that was a bad call. Let me try 10 on her. And -10. Let's isolate her head real quick. Follow world. Awesome. Okay. One last play blast, and then we'll wrap up. Okay. So I'm just gonna hide that. Play blast. Awesome. Well, there you have it, folks. 2 blocked walk cycles in exactly, okay, so we're about hour 40 there. We're 90 minutes, and an hour and 31. And I even did the calculation and showed you reference beforehand. So under 90 minutes, 2 blocked walk cycles, male and female, and we went through the whole workflow. Let me recap real quickly so that we can remember and refocus on workflow. Find the stride length. All right, place those feet and find the distance and the time that it's going to be in one stride. Okay, Then we moved the feet and did our offset with cycle on the translate Z curve. We found the up and down very roughly up and down on the hips, and at the same time did a little bit of foot roll, because that they kind of work a lot together, because you might max out that leg, but then lifting up that heel, you get all that room back. After we did that, once we got all of the basic motion in the cog and the legs working, it was like basically the most simple walk cycle with feet shuffling and hips or cog moving. Then we split. We went overboard on her hips, especially that side-to-side shuffling motion. Made sure that we created it simply and did offsets so that our workflow could be really, really, really open and really, 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 really editable. Same thing on him. We just did the exact same thing. Instead of shuffling with the hips, we just did forward and back, almost like rowing with those shoulders. Again, it just worked so easily, and it came together so easily because of how repeatable that workflow is, just to do your offsets, or sorry, to do your animation on your key frames. If you have a 20 frame walk cycle, then it's 21 frames, 1, 6, 11, 6, 20, or 16, 21, and then just offset, okay? And you saw me do that, I don't know how many times I did it, but I did it like dozens of times in front of you. And so hopefully you see now how easy it is to just dial in that animation and then slide it where it needs to go. After we went overboard in her hips and his shoulders, we started making that motion propagate down into the body. On him, it was overlapping the spine and then down into overlapping the hips. On her, it was overlap basically up the spine, and her shoulders, it looked nice to get a little bit of contrapposto so that they were working kind of opposite each other. The arms were getting distracting, so we slammed in those arms as quick as possible. We used a offset as well on those arms and a copy paste to the other side. Rig is good if you can copy and paste across the rig. It's a really good rig. And then once we had that, it was basically time for us to make the final adjustment in terms of what the character is. So we put it in way too much. So I toned it down by, I think if you want to get nitpicky, it might be a little bit more, a little bit less, but I dialed it down by about half in both of them, and then made a few fine tuned, not like super detailed, but a few finer tuned adjustments to him. Like for instance, making it so that his shoulders really were driving that twist in his body, but making sure that it didn't start going into the femoral. I didn't start unlocking those hips from the body. It made everything. So when I turned it, it actually kind of brings, you know, the rest of the body through with that shoulder turn. On her, same thing, but with the hips, I did a little bit more of a finer tune adjustment. I fixed her height. I put her a little bit more forward and lean forward, but the overlap in the shoulders and how the hips are reaching for that step. I kind of broke that up a little bit. Again, did offsets. It was pretty much, I mean, you saw the offset workflow about 1,000 times in this lecture. And what we came up with was a very, 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 very good basic male and female walk that can be totally fine-tuned. I could probably spend another 2 days, you know, on that, making it perfect, whatever the director wanted or whatever is appropriate for the show or whatever. And obviously you need to get everything in there. You need to get all the way to the fingertips, even on a walk cycle. And you need to get all the way to the tips of the toes. Of course, but this is a really great baseline. So hopefully you saw the differences, the main distinction between the male and the female. It's very simple, but it can be very confusing and it can trip you up, because something so simple, you might go overboard and not know how to get back. Okay, so hopefully the workflow I showed you, where you go overboard, but then you let those commanders dictate the rest of the body, and see how I went like this. This is the female hips and the male shoulders, and it kind of dictated the rest of the body. Hers kind of moved upwards, his moved down. Okay, so very, very simply, of course, women walk with their hips, men with their shoulders, and I hope from this workflow lecture, you got a little bit of a tip, a little bit of a roadmap on how to do the cycles yourself. You're going to get these. You're going to get these files. So you can take a look. Obviously, well, you have them already because you probably downloaded them before you watched this lecture, but there you go. Thank you for watching. If you want to see more lectures like this, tell your friends, refer them to the site because, you know, I don't do hardly any advertising. I'm on 11 Second Club and I have Google Ads, but I mean, really, this is all word of mouth. So if you want to support the site, the best thing you can do is tell your friends, sign up for the free trial. It's free. Download all these videos, watch all this stuff, and then decide later if you want to stick around. See the videos and then decide. That's what I would love if you could tell them that. So bring as many people to the site as you can and support the site. I appreciate it. If you want to have a say in what lectures are done in the future, you have a voice. You go into the forums, into the resource wish list form, and let your voice be heard. Just tell me what you want to see in a lecture in the future, and I dive in there, and I do lectures a lot from the suggested resources in the forum. So again, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned a lot. Good luck with your animation. And as always, rock on.